Hey friends. So I am here at Mount Hope, Ohio. It's really the heart of Amish country. They have Mount Hope auction and then flea market. Wednesdays are the flea market, so I've never been to the flea market here. So I thought I'd come down and finally check it out. So I don't think I'm going to be able to film because there's Amish everywhere, unfortunately. But I definitely want to respect them. So I'll come back and show you what I got. Like I said, the auctions here are anything, you name it, all kinds of livestock, animal, you know, it's animal auctions. Also, exotic animals, which I'm not so sure I know how I feel about that, but it's a huge, huge business here. And Wednesdays they have the flea market. So I'm gonna go in and I'll come out. When I come out, I'll show you if I got anything. All right, guys, see you soon. So here's part of the Mount Hope auction. Where the Amish park their buggies. All right, I'm back. I got some things. The flea market was not real big. Not a lot of antiques there. So it was mostly new things and a lot of produce and you know, food and things like that. A lot of tools. And so there wasn't a whole lot. All the items I got was from one vendor. He had a lot of ephemera. His prices were high, but he did work with me on some things. And still, I think I paid up a little bit too much for some things, but oh well. I got some stuff anyhow. Okay, hang on. I'm doing this in my car. I'm holding the phone. So, I apologize for the bumpiness and everything. So, I got these cards. And from the back, they look like playing cards. But what they are, apparently it was a game. But they have, and the guy told me these are from like the 1930s. I have no idea, you know, how old these cards themselves are, but they are black and white photos of paintings or pictures, and I believe down here is the artist and when the picture or painting was done, and you know, a title at the top. So I got a whole bunch of these with really, really cool pictures on them, you guys. If you know, if I could show you all of them, I would. So I got those. I thought that was really neat. Excuse me. Then I got this Johann Sebastian Bach book. And what's really neat about this is it's got prints of his writings. So show you if I can. Really cool. So these are not the originals, but they're his writings. So So a whole bunch of pages of those. Great for, you know, collage and journaling and stuff like that. So I got that. He threw in this Happy Easter pillowcase cover. It's kind of like burlap. He threw that in free. And then let me get some other stuff. Okay, then I got, I guess you would call it a dresser set, a mirror, brush, and comb. So here's the comb. Here is the brush. Very cool. I think these are kind of old. And then here is the mirror in very nice shape. Definitely has some weight to it, you guys. So got that. And then I got these silver plated cups. He kind of threw them in, or I didn't pay much for them. So this one says Eugene on it. It's got some kind of marking on it. I will have to get my magnifying glass out and see what that says. And then this one has initials on it and a really nice cup. I take that back. There is something on the bottom. I'll have to again look at that. Now it's got some smudge, I think from probably a, you know, some type of price tag sticker. So I don't know what to do with that, because if I try to clean that off, then I'm going to take off the patina. So, we'll see what I can do to clean that up. And that is it, you guys. That's all I got. Again, maybe paid a little bit more, especially on the cards. I think I paid too much, but oh well. They're really fun. And the cards are probably going to be sold on Instagram. I think I will try to do that, sell them through Instagram posts. I think that's easier. I'm also going to do that with some of my postcards that I've gotten, because I haven't been real successful on my sales, my live sales, selling postcards. So I will do that too. Thank you. Lots of traffic on this road. Mount Hope is really bustling with the auction, and you really have to be careful. You can't speed if you're ever in Amish country. Really watch your speed, guys, because you have to be mindful of the horse and buggies. Never, as you're coming up onto the crest of a hill, my recommendation is to slow down, because you never know, there might be a horse and buggy right at the top of that hill. And some of the roads, they are trying to allow for the horse and buggies and have a nice, have a nice
you know, side berm of the road for them, but other roads don't. So
here we're at MCC Connections. Little thrift store here in Kidron.
We'll see if I can film inside. You know me. But I'll see what I can do.
Lots of fabric.
I
picture. I need oh, here's more fabric. I need furniture for my booth. $6 on this, which is an excellent price. Blankets, pets, plant cover, remnants. Okay, so I did pretty good here at MCC Connections. Prices are pretty good here. I think what I'll do is everything's kind of wrapped up, so I will I think I'll just take a picture and show you and insert it. So I got a king size sheet set for $10. I thought that was a really good price. I've got a king bed, floral, very pretty. And then you saw, guys, they have so much fabric. I saw this pattern. It's a bunch of fabric, but it was only $2, and I was very attracted to the pattern, so I went ahead. I couldn't resist. I'm such a like a fabric hog. And I don't do enough with it. So, what else? I got plastic doilies again. Those are, I always pick those up. These seem to be newer. They're smaller. I don't think they're really vintage, but, they make great, masks for, spraying, paint and ink on fabric and paper, so great for journaling and, you know, art. So I picked those up. A pair of plastic owl salt and pepper shakers. I actually have a set of those myself. What else did I get? I got a Lennox floral, kind of like oblong bowl. It said it was like a reproduction of a very early pattern, but I think it said 1987 on it. So I got that, and I know I got some other, couple other things, but I can't remember. So I will insert a picture of what all I got. Okay, we're coming up to Schisler's Cheese House. So I'm going to see if I can film inside. I'll have to ask and see what they say. I'm always shy about it, so we'll see. Okay. Okay. So you guys, I came here as a kid. My mom would always come here and we would get our cheese, and it was so good. Our family, whenever we had family from Pittsburgh who would come to visit, mom would always make a trip out here to Schisler's to get some cheese. You know, the Swiss was really huge. And then they came out with the baby Swiss, but, really cool. So we'll see if they let me film, okay? All right, guys.
This is kind of weird, Dennis. Oh, okay, because I was going to say, I was going to work on it.
Lots of yummy stuff. Oh, gosh, they have the Easter candy. I used to love coming here as a kid. You know, they'd have all the food. And then
they would have a huge, they have a huge round block. Now they don't have, today they don't have a round block of cheese, but so they've got cheese cut up here. Oh Lord, I might have to get some. This would be good. Take a and then the trail bologna around us, Troyer's trail bologna, or this might be their own, is so good. Yep, I might have to get some of that too. I've got a deli here. Oh, Amish fry pies. Yum. Lemon, key lime, apple, blueberry, raisin. Oh gosh, I'm gonna have to stock up here.
We are gonna need counter space, but we'll still use this. And I don't know if
you want I can't pronounce this. Spitz boobin, walnut and apricot. Chocolate. They have all their jarred condiments and jams from Walnut Creek, which is very close by. Got all the tourist info because Amish country is a huge tourist destination. Berlin. And then here's our cheese. So this is the cheese round. We've got big blocks of cheese here. There's the Swiss.
We're discussing.
Okay.
This is our most famous. This is our Swiss cheese.
Right.
It used to be made in wheels. That's what this is for.
Okay, I was wondering if you still do wheels.
No, we don't do wheels anymore because the health department decided that the copper kettles there are too porous. You know, bacteria can get into them and all that. So I guess it must have killed everybody
for
the last 3 seconds.
So that's how they were made, with the copper kettle.
Yes.
I didn't know that.
It's a copper kettle and they put a cheesecloth in there and they were able to pull out a 200-pound cheese wheel.
Oh my gosh.
Outside. And that would fit right on here.
Yeah.
It was dropped through a cheese chute, which is over there. There's a trap door over there. It was dropped through a cheese chute, and we had shelves in the basement where we continued to age it. We scrubbed it off with salt brine every evening, and it was brought up here. This is an actual elevator, like a dumbwaiter. This is the door to
it. Oh, my goodness.
It's not operational right now, but it still does work. So we brought the 200-pound cheese wheels up. We would cut them inside the elevator. Then we would bring them here, and that's where we sold it from.
Oh my gosh.
Nowadays, it's made in stainless steel vats, which are long, so it's cut into 50-pound blocks. And we sell one of these blocks about every 4 hours, approximately 2,000 pounds a week.
Wow.
Yeah, about a ton a week. You double that during the holiday season.
Oh my gosh.
We have approximately 80 types of cheese.
So the rest of your cheese is like pre-cut like this, and you can get it from the case here?
Well, it's not actually pre-cut. We can cut it from there.
Oh, gotcha.
It's made taken from there. However, we do have, like, most of it's made in the local area, but of course we have some imports. Our locals like imports as well.
Okay.
We've got a lot from Denmark. We've got Havarti, Danish Blue. We have Gouda, which is from Holland, and smoked Gouda, and double cream Gouda. The Jarlsberg is from Norway. Romano is Italian. Parmesan is Italian. That's imported Parmesan. It's not the kind you find in the can.
Wow.
We have some from Canada. The goat cheese is also a Gouda. It's from Holland. We've got Manchego from Spain. The Amish butter cheese is very similar to Havarti. It's got a high butter fat content.
It's
very rich and creamy.
Oh, that's what I love.
And then, of course, the flavors, you know, they're more of cheddars. Locally made cheddars, the Bermuda onion, hot pepper, orange and white cheddar, which are medium sharp. Those are New York cheddars.
Okay.
mango fire, pepperoni cheese. Like I said, those are flavored. We also have salted and unsalted butter over here.
Wow. Yum. Oh my gosh.
Oh, you're from Ohio, huh?
Yeah. I used to come here as a kid.
Most people say gosh. You said garsh.
Okay, that was neat. It was good to get a little bit of history and see what they carry. Dennis was really nice. So I got Amish butter cheese. I got that sliced up. And then some trail bologna. And, a cherry fry pie. I couldn't resist. I love pie. So... okay, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're new here, I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel, hit the like, and hit the bell for all notifications, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.